Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
My name is Carlos.
My name is Andrea. We have been married for 29 years, and you have two children. We are from the Diocese of Bauru, from Brazil. It is our pleasure, and with enormous love in our hearts, to present to you the ECC. The Encounter of Couples with Christ, ECC, is a service of the Church to evangelize the family, the domestic church, and sanctuary of life, and to awaken couples to pastoral work, duly integrated into the overall pastoral care of the diocese, constituting a very strong instrument of family pastoral care. In this way, the ECC seeks to build the kingdom of God here and now, starting from the family, from the parish community, showing clues so that couples may find themselves again with themselves, with their children, with the community, and mainly with Christ. For this, it seeks to understand what it is to be church today, and its commitment to the dignity of the human person and social justice.
What is the origin of the ECC?
The ECC originated in 1970 in the parish of Nossa Senhora do Rosário, in Vila Pompeia, São Paulo, through the initiative of Father Alfonso Pastore. Alfonso Pastore, a priest who dedicated his life to various works of evangelization involving families, and noticing the lack of pastoral involvement of these couples, this created a restlessness in his heart. And from his restlessness, Father Alfonso Pastore, by inspiration of the Holy Spirit, created the ECC. The ECC is a reality in all of Brazil. Currently, our country has 280 dioceses, and the ECC is present in 264. That is approximately 98% of the dioceses in our country. Since April 1970, almost 3.5 million couples have experienced the ECC service throughout Brazil.
What are the objectives of the ECC?
The ECC is a service to evangelize families and to awaken couples to participate in church ministries. There are many couples who only the woman or the man participate in church, or even couples who only attend Mass but are not involved in the parish. The proposal of the ECC is to involve the couple pastorally in the parish pastoral work. The ECC seeks familiarity with the Word of God and with the liturgical rites, with Christian life. It is not only doctrine, it is above all reality and mystery. For this reason, the ECC also has the purpose of introducing couples to the life of the parish, participating in pastoral movements and service, in a life of personal and community prayer.
How the ECC has developed?
The Encounter of Couples with Christ was conceived to be developed in three distinct, indispensable, and interrelated stages, each with its own characteristics and purposes. One stage prepares to the other and must be observed from a growth of its members and of their community. The third stage, the encounter, evangelizing and missionary, is the awakening. It is the call to couples who are far from the church. The third stage of DCC aims to awaken couples to live their marriage and family in a human and Christian way. It awakens conjugal spirituality. The couples who participate in the first stage are invited to participate in a post-meeting, which is not yet the second stage. This motivates the couples to begin their involvement in the community, to create a fraternal living together in the parish. The couples will participate in couples groups, in small communities with other couples, where they will practice their formation, their participation, their integration into the community, until they reach the second stage. Unfortunately, not all couples complete the second stage, and many end up getting lost along the way. However, those who follow all the stages become involved in the parish and become active, living Catholicism, Catholic doctrine, and engaged in the community. The second stage of DCC is the reencounter. It is catechetical. It's a deepening, a proposal of commitment. It uses reflection and is for couples who are engaged and those who wish to be engaged. The third stage is the commitment, which is transformative and is for couples who seek to change the unjust structures of our society.
What is the spirit of the ACC?
The encounter of couples with Christ is not a movement. It does not aim to bind couples to itself, nor should couples want to be bound to the ACC. The ACC Family Ministry Service is essentially parish-based. This is its fundamental characteristic. The parish will attend to its couples within its concrete reality and possibilities, promote the evangelization and engagement of couples in the parish pastoral activities. The ACC wants to be a means, a stage, a passage, a bridge. The goal is not the ACC. The goal is the kingdom of God in all the parishes. The ACC is a service to families. It is done by couples for couples, aiming to awaken them to live their marriage, their family, unite the spouses more, leading them to understand each other better, to establish a greater relationship and dialogue with their children, open paths of growth if they decide for the gospel message for Christ's church. The ACC is also a service that seeks to present to couples a clear and living vision of the gospel of Jesus Christ and of the church today. Through its documents and encyclicals, and its social doctrine. The originality of the ACC in relation to other movements and services of the Church to families lies in that it, under the guidance of the national, regional, and diocesan councils, is organized and carried out at parish level. In every ECC service, one through is fundamental. Man is only an instrument. It is God who converts and changes people. We are only servants of God. The spirituality of the ECC is founded on five basic points: giving, poverty, simplicity, joy, and prayer. Remember that the purpose is to seek out stranger couples, to love them, to position them, giving them a vision of their reason for being as a vital cell of humanity, to open for them a ways of fraternal communion in the parish community, and to enable them to be co-responsible in pastoral service. Its mission is to reach all couples residing within the parish boundaries: intellectuals, illiterate, poor, owners, workers, bosses, teachers, all together participating in the same gathering. This is the sign that it is church. The characteristic is parochiality.
What is the ECC parish structure like?
The first stage of the ECC in the parish is organized by a leading team composed of the priest and five couples from the parish. This team has among its attributions the coordination of all the activity related to the first stage of the ECC, and to reflect on the involvement of the couples in the pastorals of the parish, giving them conditions for this.
How do the meetings happen?
The meetings are held on weekends, Friday night, Saturday all day, and Sunday until late afternoon. It is composed of lectures, testimonies, group dynamics, and other activities. All activities are geared towards the couple, husband and wife. We will have the opportunity to reflect on various aspects of marriage life, of family life. Absolute secrecy about the contents of the meeting must be maintained. Trying to fulfill its missionary action, aiming to keep alive the initial spirit of the ECC, its purposes and characteristics, its unity and integrity, the ECC has a document at a national level that allows it to provide all dioceses and parishes with a secure orientation, seeking to improve its evangelizing line. Thus, the ECC follows its own norms contained in the national documents. This is valid for all ECC in all parishes in all parts of Brazil. In order to give continuity to the service that the ECC gives to the church and to the improvement of its leaders, national and regional congresses are held periodically.
Who can participate in the ECC?
Couples who have the sacrament of matrimony or who have no impediment to receive it. The ECC has a very viable purpose. It's a service that brings great contribution to the church. In these 50 years of ECC in Brazil, it has helped in evangelization. It has improved catechesis. Many people who have experienced the ECC participate as pastoral agents in their parishes. Vocations have been born from children of encounters. In short, the ECC is a joy of God, of Christ for our church. Let us pray to God that the Holy Spirit, who inspired Father Alfonso Pastore to create the ECC in 1970, may continue to guide us in the work of this beautiful pastoral work of evangelization of the families of our church.
We believe in life. We believe in family.
Thank you so much.